Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and let's do some more laddering on the Hunter deck. Thank you everyone who has been watching and liking the series thus far, along with my other content, including the StarCraft II construction course series that we've been doing. Or StarCraft II golf course construction series, is what I meant to say, thanks to my dyslexia. Yeah, we're just going to be rolling with the Hunter deck. And as you saw in that last video, you could see what happens when you are on the receiving end of Hearthstone's unlucky RNG, and that is normally the case with me, and I feel like I played that last game pretty well, but what can you do? If you got the cards, you can make the moves. If you don't have the cards, you can't make the move. So it looks like I'm going up against another Hunter, and this is going to be interesting on that, especially since I go first. Snake Trap is a good card to have on the on-deck circle, and Lisa Hounds is not a good card to have in the on-deck circle. I will keep the Animal Companion, and I can't really... That's not too bad. I'll take the Raptor. I'll take the Raptor, hopefully summon Misha. Huffer is not bad either, and Leoric is also not that bad either. Or Leoc. I think it's Leoc, not Leoric. Or Leoric. How you pronounce that. And, yeah, we're just going to be keep doing this laddering, see if I can get back up to into the diamond ladder, as my opponent is going to turn one a boar, and Timberwolf comes out. I'm going to go ahead and get the Raptor out. Most likely he's going to send the boar into the Raptor, or he could Arcane Shot the Raptor not have to lose the boar. So unlike paladins, unlike druids, unlike shamans, hunters do not rely on keeping their minions alive. And I was going to use a hunter's mark, and that was a little bit surprising, but okay. He had to use three cards for the cost of my one card, and that's fine with me. Another animal companion comes out. How lucky do we get? We get Leoc. So, and he can't charge. So I like it when Rexxar gets mad. Rexxar and Garrosh have two of the funnier "I'm mad" emotes in the game. But what Leoc does, by the way, is it buffs all other minions by one, which is a very, very good card indeed, especially for a three cost. Of course, getting Leoc it's never guaranteed. You have to go through the animal companion roulette, I guess if you want to call it that. But one thing I like about Leoc is that he is a 2/4, and he's very difficult to kill, especially on turn three, unless he has a kill command with a beast already out there, which he doesn't. So he's going to coin here and use a Starving Buzzard and probably throw down a Raptor as well. Yep, there it is. That'll give him a guaranteed card draw here. And I get my own kill command, and Leoc does count as a beast. So I could kill command the... Let's see here. I could kill command the Raptor and get the Buzzard off the field, and I think that's what I have to do here. So let's kill command the Raptor, let's play the Timberwolf, let's get rid of the Buzzard here so he doesn't have any more card draw. And I think that is the better of the two, instead of putting out the Grizzly out there, because I don't want to... If you get a chance, with Hunters, one thing you have to realize is if you get a chance, in my opinion anyway, to limit or to cut off their card draw with the Buzzard, you should take it. If you have the ability to remove a minion, you definitely need to take it. So Silverback Patriarch comes out along with a Wisp, which costs nothing. And that is it. I get my own Starving Buzzard coming out here, and I am okay with that. I think what I'm going to do is I definitely want to get the Snake Trap out, and I definitely would like to get the Buzzard out because those two synergize beautifully. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the Starving Buzzard. I'm going to play the Snake Trap. And again, the reason why I did that is because I'm not expecting him to go for the Buzzard here. I am going to, I'll throw 3 damage on that. I'm not going to throw away the Timberwolf, however. And what the Snake Trap does is once one of my minions is attacked, it will summon it will trigger the trap card of the Snake Trap and get 3 snakes to come out. And as long as the Buzzard is alive, that's a guaranteed 3, because they count as beasts, that's a guaranteed 3 cards I get out of that. And that's the reason why it is a nice combination to have. It's a little gimmicky, but in the end, it's not. It's if it works out the way you want it to, then it's very beautiful indeed. So the Wisp is going to attack me. He's going to take the Silverback into Leoc, and that's going to trigger the snake trap. And there's my snakes, and that is going to trigger my Buzzard as well. So here they come, unleash the hounds, Houndmaster, and the third card in this card draw is going to be another Timberwolf. I'm fine with that. Unfortunately, that does debuff everything, but now, as you see here, my opponent is going to be in a little bit of trouble. I do have six mana. I want to get rid of the Silverback Patriarch, and really the only way I can do that, because I want to maximize my damage here, is I'm going to use Arcane Shot on the Silverback Patriarch. I still have enough mana to get the Houndmaster out, buff the Buzzard, and I can also unleash the Hounds and give it charge, or I could get a Timberwolf, which does the same thing as Unleash the Hounds, and I still get a card draw, and I'm able to sink all this damage into the Hunter. And as you see here, it is a beastly, no, well, pun intended, no pun intended, but it is a beastly, nice, beastly synergy there with the Snake Trap and the Starving Buzzard. And Lord of the Arena comes out. I'm fine with that. My Snake Traps and my Buzzards have already done more than enough. And I will actually be able to end the game next turn. So what I'm going to do is I really don't need any more card draw. I would like to get more damage. And so what I'm going to do is get the bear out, and that maximizes my board. I am going to run Unleash the Hounds, and I am just going to end the game here. So down goes the taunts, down goes the hunter. Even if I needed more, I'd be able to steady shot him, but I didn't need him. So that is going to be that one. And a very good game for us to start off with. Certainly a nice change of pace than running into the regular rigmarole of paladins and mages. So we'll do one more here and then wrap it up. Unless this shaman or whatever decides to leave like in that last video, which was pretty funny. But right there you see that is why I like the synergy of the Hunter deck. It doesn't require a whole lot of crazy good cards in order to work. And you know, even being in the one-star gold league, it doesn't really mean much. Again, the leagues in Hearthstone, until you get past Diamond League, it really doesn't matter. As long as you play enough games, you can get in any league you want in Hearthstone. So our first draw comes out. It's not that great, not that bad either. Unleash the Hounds is good, but I don't need it. I like the Animal Companion. Houndmaster I'm going to use with the Animal Companion. We'll get rid of Unleash the Hounds, and unfortunately we get Tundra Rhino, which isn't that bad, but not really the greatest. I was going to hope for Explosive Shot or something like that. Multi-Shot would be even better. Starving Buzzard comes out. Obviously, I'm not going to coin into that because I have no way to protect it. And on top of that, the Mage has many, many different ways they can easily get rid of that on turn two. Arcane Missile. They could Arcane Explosion into Fire Blast, which is Janna's hero power. There's no sense into putting your Buzzard out there like that. Snake Trap comes out, and that is a very, very nice card indeed. As we saw in the game not too long ago, I like Snake Traps. However, right now, there's no real reason to play it because, again, I have no protection for my Buzzard. I think what I'm going to do is just trade damage, go blow for blow here with Janna, and not do that. Again, the thought process there is that the snake trap only activates if your minions get attacked. I don't have any minions out there. I want to make sure that if I have the chance to synergize the Buzzard with the Snake Trap, then I'm going to set up for that, and I'm not going to force the measure or perhaps waste the Snake Trap. So Arcane Shot is a good play here. And I'm going to just steady shot and keep pace with Janna. Again, I'm in no real hurry to get the Snake Trap and Buzzard combination out there. And unless something big and scary comes out, Mogus Shen Warden is not big and scary. I don't have to really rush the situation. Here, I'm going to go ahead and play the Animal Companion just to see what I can get. And I do get Leok, so that is a pretty good card indeed to draw. I don't really want to play the Timberwolf. I could coin here and play the Buzzard. However, I have no way to really protect it. I want to make sure that I can set myself up for the Buzzard to synergize with the Snake Trap. So I'm going to roll it over and see if Leok will survive this. If he does, then I'm set up very, very nicely to play three cards next turn. And he is not going to survive it. However, I did use a Frostbolt for my opponent. And that is fine by me. So another Tundra Rhino comes out, and that is, again, not the card that I want. However, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the Rhino and start doing some damage to get this Mogus Shen Warden out of the way. I'm not going to coin here because, again, I'm in no rush to get anything out there. With Lord of the Arena comes out, now I have a good reason to start throwing out cards. And I will certainly do just that. So I think I'm going to go ahead and put the Houndmaster buff the Tundra Rhino here. I can't kill the Lord of the Arena, but what I can, well, I could actually technically kill it if I threw the, if I threw out the Timberwolf here. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the Buzzard out. This is most likely going to, this is probably going to trigger a Flame Strike coming out from my opponent, which is fine with me. I'm going to coin. I'm going to get the Timberwolf out, thereby doing, I will be able to do enough damage here. Oh, and look at that. A Bestial Wrath comes out. I wish I had that one card before, because I would be able to not have to throw away this Tundra Rhino here. But I am going to take out the Ocean Warden. I'm not going to play anything else right now. There's no point to it. My my Rhino is now 5/5, and that is well out of the range of Flame Strike. He is going to Polymorph it, however, which is something that I also was kind of expecting. Arcane Missile comes out, and unfortunately for my opponent, good for me, they didn't hit anything of really importance. And he is going to Fire Blast the Timberwolf, which debuffs everything. And he's going to inflict 2 damage on himself, his tank. At least the Hounds comes out, and that is fine by me. I'm going to go ahead and get my second Buzzard out. Do I want to get the second Buzzard out? Yeah. Because what I can do is Snake Trap here, and I can play my Raptor. And, oh, a Deadly Shot comes out, and that is pretty nice indeed. I think what I want to do is I definitely would like to get that Lord of the Arena out. The only way I can do that is unleash the Hounds. I can't use Bestial Wrath. I could have, but the Bestial Wrath, I wouldn't. The Raptor wouldn't be attacking it anyway right now. So what I'm going to do is trade the Raptor, get the Lord of the Arena out, and do lots of damage. And now I've set myself up to have the possibility, unless he Flame Strikes here, or Polymorphs the Buzzard, I will have the ability to synergize my Buzzard with my Snake Trap. And as you see here, he does not have the ability to do that. Kill Command comes out, another beautiful card here in this regard, because I can just Kill Command the... I Kill Command the Booty Bay Bodyguard. I can either Bestial Wrath or use Deadly Shot. In this case, I'm going to use Bestial Wrath because there's no real reason for me to use Deadly Shot. That's a very, very powerful card, and I don't need to be using that right now. I don't need to be wasting. So I'm going to go ahead and Bestial Wrath the Buzzard here and take out the Grizzly Bear. I still have my Sheep, hilariously enough. I was able to do that without having to use my Deadly Shot. And I still have a Rhino as well if I need a quick charge, two charge damage, I guess if you want to call it that. So what will this be? Most likely going to be, oh, it's going to be Fireball. So that's a pretty expensive card he used on the Buzzard. So unfortunately, we didn't get to synergize the Squire, Snake Trap with the Starving Buzzard this time around.
Ready, sir.
But yeah, you have to get pretty lucky in order for that to happen. And I don't know if I can end the game here. Let's see, that's two... So yeah, I can actually just end the game here. So that is going to be this game, and I will take the win over a mage. So it's always satisfying when you beat a mage. But yeah, and look at that, we actually get to 2-star gold league. That's pretty good. So that is going to do it for this one. Pretty short, but pretty fun. I'm not going to really do a third one right now, as I'm good with 13 minutes for 2 matches. So thank you very much for watching, everyone. As always, if you like what you saw, let me know down below. If you didn't like what you saw or heard, leave me a comment down below as well. Thank you very much for supporting the channel and myself, along with the Hearthstone content, along with the other content that I do. Hope you're having a great day. And of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.